BuySod, North Georgia Turf, and SuperSod are pleased to present the game-changing drought-tolerant Bermudagrass TIFTUF for customers in the Southeast. This turf grass has been observed and tested by the University of Georgia since 1992 and was made available for sale in 2015. Multiple tests against other Bermuda grass varieties have shown that TIFTUF is superior in drought tolerance, has early spring green up, stays green later into the fall months, and is traffic tolerant, among other impressive characteristics. This dark green turf grass has a fine texture and matches the standard Tifway 419 Bermuda until there is a drought. As UGA turf grass researcher Brian Schwartz is about to explain, TIFTUF is drought tolerant.
As the drought continued, the moisture in the soil underneath our TIFTUF plots remained for longer. And you could see it dramatically on top. As the Tifway and TifSport plots became dormant with drought, the TIFTUF plots did not, they remained. And it was a direct correlation to the moisture level in the soil. And it was really an exciting kind of discovery, because this is a great type of drought tolerance. If it goes brown, that's okay. But we would like a grass that stays green for longer and can save water. And not just save a little water, our results found that we could save up to 38% more water than a variety such as Tifway. And if you expand that on a city or a state or even the South, that's a huge amount of water savings.
TIFTUF holds up under traffic or wear and tear better than other typical Bermuda grasses. What exactly does this mean for your home? It means that if you have children and big dogs, TIFTUF will hold up under feet pounding on the lawn, having fun being dogs and kids. Because it's a Bermuda grass, it will quickly repair itself from any damage incurred while your family is enjoying their time on the lawn. Here's how Brian Schwartz tested traffic tolerance.
So we copied a machine developed at Michigan State called the Katie Traffic Simulator. We had cleats on the bottom of an aerifier, and these springs and compression and cleats actually simulate the wear in between the hashes on a football field or around the goal box on a soccer field. And over years of research here on the Tifton campus, at our plots at the ABAC campus, we were able to impose wear on TIFTUF, on Celebration, on TIF Grand, on Tifway, on Patriot, and some others, and we were able to watch their wear as they decreased in turf quality over the season, as you would expect with a tremendous amount of traffic. But we also saw the recovery each week. And it was these trials that led us to believe that not only is this a drought-tolerant grass, but TIFTUF is also a wear-tolerant grass, which is explained by the mechanisms it has. When it's well-watered and when it's fertilized, it can recover.
Along with drought and traffic tolerance, studies reveal that TIFTUF greens up faster in the spring than other typical southern Bermuda grasses. While it looks good earlier, it also stays green later in the fall months and maintains visual appeal longer than standard Tifway.
So, with the data we were pulling out, there was actually more questions. And one of the biggest questions that people will have is, well, how will TIFTUF do in the shade? So rather than start a formal trial with shade cloth, I wanted to know how they would do in the real world. And to do that, we picked a home lawn in 2013 that we could plant with big pine trees, with dogwoods. We bought light bars, and we were able to measure the intensity of the sun over the entire day for several days out in the full sun, and correlate that and relate that back to the intensity of the sun underneath these pine trees, or underneath the dogwood. And the pine trees, they allow sun in the morning and in the evening, but you have heavy shade in the afternoon. So the light intensity underneath the dogwood tree is very low, because it only really allows sunlight in the very early morning and in the late afternoon. And so we're able to maintain pretty good quality in most places. We're able to avoid the drought that roots cause, and able to make energy even with the lower sunlight. And really, that lawn was the start. That was where we really decided that, hey, this has a good application for homeowners.
On top of drought tolerance, traffic tolerance, and shade resistance, TIFTUF is exhibiting exceptional transplanting success. In a short time, customers are seeing quick establishment on their sports fields,
lawns, and recreation areas.
Prior to release, we planted a lawn in Florida because it's a different environment than we are, and it can be shady and it's real world. So we put a grass in Jacksonville, Florida. At the same time, we also planted one in Atlanta, Georgia on the red clay, where it's totally different than Tifton. And watching the grass there do good in the sun, do good in the shade, it's been comforting as the developers to know that it does do well out there in the real world under homeowner management. To answer our real questions about drought tolerance in TIFTUF, I think we had to get out of the Southeast. And so we put a lawn in Austin, Texas on their limestone shelf in the hill country in a neighborhood where the builder mandates Tifway in the front lawn and you can do whatever you want in the back. And so this particular homeowner, we put TIFTUF in the back lawn, and in the droughts of the last year or two, TIFTUF has shined over Tifway and really made us proud and the homeowner happy, and he's just asking us when can he replace his front lawn with the TIFTUF. So it's the results where we believe that other Bermuda grasses are gonna go dormant in a drought, where TIFTUF will remain green and healthy and strong, that'll make it a success, not only in Georgia, not only in the Southeast, but hopefully the whole Southern United States and even other parts of the world where it can be grown. And it's the years and years of research where we've come to the conclusion that TIFTUF is more drought tolerant than Tifway, than Tif Grand, than Celebration, than Latitude 36. It greens up faster than many of the other Bermuda grasses. It goes dormant later to save our resources so that we can use water in other places.